Nate is waiting in the background. The dogs are waiting. All right, you guys, here we go. We're going to bring up Nate from Landcloud Adventures. Hey, Nate, how's it going?
Hello, hello. I guess I should wave with this hand so I don't clock Dallas there. That's all people come to watch is the dogs. So,
well, they are beautiful dogs. What kind of dogs are those for those that don't know?
Fluffy white ones, known as Samoyeds, also known as Land Clouds, which is why I named the channel that.
Awesome. How long have you had them?
Oh, gosh. Pippa, she's hiding back there somewhere. There she is.
There they are.
I've had her 2 years in Dallas. I want to say five. I think 5 years she's been with me. Because I got her when she was like 1.5, I think, and she's about 6.5 now. So
those are well-trained dogs, Nate. I watch your videos. Like when you did the taste test with them, my dog.
That's one of the few things they know. You gotta wait for your food.
You know, my dogs were already like 6 and 7 or 7 and 8 years old when I got them. And there is no way, because you challenged me to do that video too, and I'm going to do it this week, but I'm going to just embarrass myself because there's no way they're going to sit and wait like your dogs did.
Well, just have the video camera going and then put it up, I suppose.
I'll just edit it so it looks like all of a sudden the food just magically appeared in front of them.
But the nice thing also is I don't have to show when they misbehave. I guess I did show the one video of Dallas. She talks back quite a bit. They are very smart dogs, but they are very stubborn dogs. And so they know what you want them to do, but they don't always do it.
Now, isn't this funny? Kevin's like, bald head, beard, black shirt. I feel like I'm looking in the mirror.
I can't believe Kevin is here. I know it's not me, it's you, but he was one of the first ones I watched. And I sent him a message at some point saying, you know, I see all these channels of females doing the solo van life and people plug into that. He was the first one that I watched that was like, you know, maybe a guy can do a YouTube channel on it as well. So he's kind of an inspiration that way. So it's crazy that he's here watching me.
I know. And his live streams are so busy.
Yeah.
I aspire to have mine like that.
I don't know. That's a fast chat. He's got some good moderators to keep track of all of that.
I got some pretty good moderators too, don't you worry. I think Megan single-handedly herself can handle it, right, Going Green Mom?
Yeah, but you need one moderator assigned to your brother.
Oh, yeah.
And then I think another for Mike. And then if I'm
one for you.
That's true too. Maybe half.
That is a good idea. But you know, my brother is a moderator, so I don't know what we're gonna do with that one.
I remember that.
So it hasn't been that long that you've been a part of this van life community. When did you start your channel?
So I left my job and started this whole crazy idea towards the end of October. And it was an old colleague who's an old retired lawyer who was terrible with technology. And he was the one that was like, you know, if you're going to quit your job and go up to like Alaska with your dogs, you might as well start a YouTube channel. So the person that gave me the idea was the last person I thought would actually recommend it. But I thought, what the heck, I'll log in and I'll create an account and just see, you know, I wasn't a big YouTuber and I didn't really know a whole lot what it was about. And so it's been a lot of testing just to see if it was going to be worth it. Right. You want to spend a month or two. I didn't want to invest a lot of money in equipment or anything if it wasn't going to be worth my time. So I think my first real video that I really started editing and stuff was towards the end of November or December, and I've been doing a lot since then.
Well, you've had some real success. That short had like 250,000 views.
I still can't believe it. It was great.
I'm like, well, you have over 1,000 subscribers, and I'm like, what the hell?
And I'll be honest, I still need like 3,800 hours. So people keep telling me like you're monetized. I'm like, no, I'm not. And the funny part of that was I didn't know this, but obviously you learn real quick when they don't count. But that video, like you said, it had 220,000 views that one day. And I just started logging in. you know Danny at Griswold Family Vacay, he started growing pretty quick after 900. And so I logged in that night and I saw my numbers jump by like 30 on my friends. And I thought something was wrong because we had just played Cahoots and there's trolls and stuff in there and hackers. And I thought something was going on. And I was about to message him on Facebook and be like, okay, is something going on with these new friends that you're getting? Because I just jumped a bunch. And it literally seconds before I sent him that message, I looked and I was like, what is going on with this video? And it just...
So you actually got to watch it happening? You were just checking at the right time?
I was... Rachel was doing a live with Doug and Nikki. And she had asked us to come in because she was a little bit nervous and wanted us to come ask questions and stuff. And so I went over there and I asked the questions that I did. And I didn't have any more and the dogs were getting kind of anxious. So I took them on a walk. And when I came back is when I sat back down to try to catch up. And I looked, I was like, because I had just looked like 15 minutes before. So I knew it was like 30 in like 15 minutes. And I was like, something ain't right. It still ain't right. I can't believe it, but I'm not going to complain.
So you got a lot of new subscribers from that short alone.
Yeah, right? It was, I think, officially over 900 now.
But those watch hours didn't count because it was on the short shelf, right?
That's what I was going to say. That's the thing I learned that night, because I don't have the hours because I'm very new and I haven't done live streaming yet or anything. Mm-hmm. And I've been doing a lot of shorts because they're pretty easy and the dogs, you know, dogs are good content for that. But I learned that night because it had over 500 hours. And then somebody's like, yeah, those aren't going to count. I was like, no.
Yeah. So, I had one video go, or no, it was like a previous interview. And all of a sudden, one evening, I got 1,000 views on it. But they were all in India, so they were all short views. And I made 44 cents.
Well, what were they logging? Do they speak English?
In India, yeah, a lot do speak English, okay. But for some reason it got pushed there. I have had no big success. That's my biggest thing that had ever happened. But you, I mean, that short was worth it. I mean, it brought so many people to your channel and obviously people that do love the dogs.
Yeah, and I'm a very analytical guy. I work in banking and stuff. So that's part of what I've really enjoyed about this is watching the analytics a little bit too much. The first short that at the time I thought took off was like 6,000 to 7,000 views now. And that was over in Europe because it launched in the morning here. So that was interesting to watch. It was like Spain, UK, Russia, and that sort of thing. So this other one that really took off was like the prime time here. So I was really interested to wonder what percent were going to be from the US somebody asked me that before I had the analytics. And I said, judging by the names that I can see, I'm guessing it's a lot of like South America. And so when the numbers came in, it was like a little over 20% from the US, 20% from Brazil, 10% from Mexico, and then a whole smorgasbord of stuff. So I might have to learn Spanish if I'm going to keep these people around, is what I joke about.
I don't think you have to worry about doing that. You never know where it's going to hit. But now it's time to do the traveling part, but you're still in your house. Yep. How long is that going to be?
Oh, I'm hoping. So I started my MBA this semester. I just started last week and the finals are the first week of May. So I'm hoping by the time the finals are done, maybe I'll list the house right after that. I plan to do a bunch of kind of test travels, short, just down to the little RV park and that sort of thing. Cause I've never done it. Not even as like a guest. So, other than watching everybody's videos, I don't have a clue what I'm doing. So there'll be a lot of good, fun failure videos of what did Nate screw up for a few months. But those will be fun, right?
Yeah, we'll I thought videos like that were going to make me famous because I'm really good at screwing stuff up.
Right? And you got to be able to laugh at yourself.
Well, you know, sometimes it's hard to know how much do you really share because a lot of people think it's funny. And at the same time, you're allowing yourself to be extremely vulnerable.
Yeah. And you're always going to have those haters out there that you just never know.
Yeah.
DJ will come over and throw something at me.
Okay. So I'm going to back things up a little bit. You know, you had said retired. How old are you?
So I'm 38. And when I left, I decided, I said, I'm going to resign. I'm going to go on the road for 3 years. And before I gave my notice, I said, you know what? Why don't I phrase it more positively than resigning and going traveling? I'm just going to retire because I don't plan to work. And so I told them I was retiring. And of course, I worked for the government, for a banking regulator. And at first, they just kind of were like, okay. And I guess they asked a few questions about, well, do you have health issues that would allow you to do an early retirement or anything like that? And I was like, no, I'm just going to retire. And I always told my first boss at the FDIC, who always talked about her 401k and stuff, I said, you know, I won't say her name, you know, you can really retire at whatever age you want. You just have to live affordably or move to another country where it's cheaper to live. Or, you know, we all get stuck in this mindset that you've got to work till you're 60 and you've got to have, you know, certain things and a house and all of that, which I mean, there's some truth to it, depending on what your expectations are. But I've never really followed the rules quite how people expect you to. So, no, I told them I was going to retire. And then a week later, they came back before my last day and said, you know, the regional office has requested that you clarify that you're not actually retiring. But before they did that, I got an email out from DC, because the first way we phrased it and the first way they sent it in was I was retiring. And so I already got an email from DC about like the retirement newsletter. So send in your picture and your little blurb or whatever. So I'd already done that. Mm-hmm. So I never clarified that I was retiring with the regional office. I just said, it doesn't matter to me. You know, I'm saying I'm retiring. And then
you resigned or you retired, right?
Yeah. They're always worried about perception. So they don't want other people being like, well, how did he retire at 38? You know, that sort of thing.
Oh, hang on. I'm trying to learn how to edit, Nate. So I was playing around and oh my goodness, I laughed so much. Just being so silly. Anyways, so you are retiring or you resigned?
I guess I resigned. And the ironic thing is the weekend I posted it, the day after I was technically gone, I posted it on Facebook. And of course I said I retired, because I said, I'm going to frame it as retirement. And an old friend that started there with me called me and said, we need to talk. And so he started his own business. So I'm actually going to be working. I told him two conditions. I want part-time. I don't want to work more than 1 or 2 weeks a month, and I'm traveling. So I'm doing it remotely. I'm not going to the banks. So he was more than happy to have me. He said, I think he did a LinkedIn. I went up and took my professional pictures a week or at the beginning of the year. And he posted on LinkedIn last Monday. And he said the post got on Wednesday. So within 2 days, it had 1,200 views. And he started getting calls for like new clients and stuff. I was like, maybe I should be asking for more money from you.
So we have a question for you, but I did just get another super chat that's requesting some more moose milk, please. Why, of course, Alan. You're special for you.
With you, I can be sad. With you, just take my hand and fly up through the dreams where the skies are so clear. I wanna stay with you.
I'm actually gonna make some more today, but my editing software didn't want to work.
I'm gonna do my own super chat celebration.
Are you?
Well, I just gave them a treat.
Your dogs keep coming up every time we have music playing.
Well, that's because I give them a treat every time.
Oh.
Every time you get a super chat, they're getting a treat.
Oh, I thought they were really getting in a groove back there. So we have a question for you from Going Green Mom. Are you planning a mini retirement or going back after the MBA or just completely work optional? Like, so you're upgrading your education, so I'm imagining you plan to go back to work.
Maybe. I haven't decided. And I kind of ruined it because I said I am going to be working part-time, right? My friend that's hiring me, he said, I know I'm not paying you what you're worth, but, you know, and I said, that's okay. You're giving me the flexibility that I want. And so if it works out with him, I'm already qualified for what he's asking me to do. I don't really even need the MBA to do it. So if I love it and I just want to stay traveling and I want to keep doing what we're doing, I kind of have the option to keep doing it. But what I currently do is compliance. and I'm a very analytical person, and it's not very analytical. So it does, it doesn't fit my skill set or my natural, you know, curiosities very much. So that's probably the reason I, at some point I'll probably change into investments and finance and that sort of thing, but.
Well, but you must have some saved up, like you're ready. Obviously you put some planning and thought into this that you knew even the 3-year mark. Hoping that this YouTube channel is going to become enough to, I mean, everybody needs to dream. What is your dream with your YouTube channel, Nate?
I have no idea. When I started, like I said, the one guy threw it out to me and I thought it wouldn't be a bad way to document it. If I'm going to go do this thing for 3 years and travel the country, it was more about documenting it and having the memories documented.
Yeah.
And also learning. I mean, I'm not into photography. I've never edited a video. I've never done an RV. I've done a lot of travel because it was part of my work, but not, it was, you know, plane and hotel and all of that. So I don't know. It'll go where it goes. I check the numbers every day and it's kind of nice to see them go up, but I think
you will definitely be able to support yourself in a very short time. But
it's kind of overwhelming that now that I'm going to be starting school and work, I've got to start prioritizing, like, okay, what really is the thing I got to get done this week or want to get done? So we'll see.
So what are you going to be traveling in, Nate? What is it that exactly that you did buy?
So I bought a 21 foot Jayco travel trailer, X Flight XLS or something like that. I was going to try to go cheaper and smaller and more compact, but when I went and started looking and I went into some of the teardrops and some of the pop-ups with extendables, and then I went into one that I looked at and I just imagined the dogs being a lot happier in it. And so I spent more money on it. I bought it new because I don't have experience with repairing it or anything like that. So I'm hoping that.
Oh, yeah. Do you have a cup already to pull it around? And
I don't. That's the crazy part. I have a RAV4. I bought the trailer. Well, I bought the trailer because I wanted the dogs to practice in it, especially Pippa. She's got a lot of fear. She's from a really bad situation. Good girl. So I got it. It's parked out in the driveway. We, especially early before it got cold here, did a lot of practicing and they warmed up to it really well. It's kind of the same thing. Every time they go out, they get treats, that sort of thing. So that it's very, they love going out there now.
Software stuff to bring the volume down. That's the thing. You don't know until you, everything's so much trial and error. And yeah. The stuff you've started has been so successful. Like, how do you even, where do you go from having something get 250,000 hits?
Well, to be honest, I'm copying myself. I just released some shorts that I'm hoping to do the same thing. We never know. Did a video with both of them missing a treat and slowed it down for slow motion because people seem to like that. I think that's why that video was so successful. You get fluffy dogs and you slow it down. So
mm-hmm.
He did it for the dogs. Thank you, Kevin.
Angela says that they're so cute. I forget now, earlier I caught a glimpse. Someone is asking, what kind of vacuum do you use or how do you deal with all the hair?
Do I have, oh, no, I don't have it in here. It's inevitable that it's going to be there. And that's going to be one of the disasters in the trailer is I'm going to have to vacuum probably twice a day and constantly brush them. If you get behind on brushing, the hair is going to be there, but it does help if you can keep up on that. Come spring, and I'll probably have to do a video on it. That's when they shed their under or one of their coats. And it's bad. It is just terrible. And so if you bathe them and then you got to use a special blow dryer that's got enough horsepower because it's bad if their skin doesn't dry. They'll get like an irritation and that sort of thing. So you need a special, you're supposed to have this special, really powerful blow dryer. But as they're shedding, like, I have to like take 3 breaks because it blows all the hair out and it's like you're in a snowstorm in your bathroom. I've got to wear a mask because otherwise I'm just breathing it in. And yeah, I'm going to have to do a video come April when they start shedding.
That would be great. Megan is saying that the fluff looks so cool in slow motion because you did some slow motion on there. And it makes me think of a model that brushes her hair back all slow motion. That's your dogs.
Well, if you look over here, because this is their room, I have that giant fan that I had bought for my treadmill. It's like a gym fan. So it's like the biggest fan you can buy. And I was playing around with it to see how it would come out. But I ended up having another video in the wind that I released this morning that was actually a little bit, it blew harder because it was really windy about a week ago. So I'm trying to have fun with it and I'm trying to take advantage of it. Why not, right?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And I think a lot of people are going to enjoy watching your videos because obviously because of you and the content you're putting out, but your fan base right now, you know, is all about the dogs.
Yeah. Absolutely. Everybody's told me that and I listen. That's what Johnny was the first one. She said, just put those dogs on camera. I said, okay.
Oh, this is so funny. Karen says those dogs will be trained for the audio cues from Moose Milk and Epic Shit. They'll expect treats whenever you listen to my live streams. Maybe we can get them on a schedule, Nate.
Right.
So this is a good question. V wants to know, how will you find mobile doggy wash places on the road? Some pet stores have them. Some car washes have the dog washes too.
So, I mean, this spring, I'll still have the house when I need to do that and blow them out. And then I'll be going up to South Dakota for a couple months to be safe and stay by my dad's. Because, you know, it's tornado season. We're in a trailer kind of testing. So this year I'm not worried about it. And what surprises people is they do not require a lot of baths. Even if they get into the mud, you don't have to typically bathe them because it's their two coats that just naturally it's on the outer coat. They kind of brush it off. A lot of it falls out in the house. So there's more cleaning because of that. But yeah. I might give them 2 or 3 baths a year. So it's not many at all.
Yeah. I think a lot of people don't realize that if you're bathing your dogs too much, it's not good for them.
Yeah, and I've had it once where I didn't get Dallas dried enough, and she got that skin irritation or infection, and we had to shave her down to dry it out. So I just started doing it only when they really need it.
Yeah, for sure. So you're going to do...
It comes off just like that.
You're going to do some part-time traveling to get them used to it now. So where are you located right now, Nate?
So right now I'm basically in the Omaha area. And my dad lives up in the Sioux Falls area. My sister's in Nashville. So I'll probably do one quick run out to see my sister and then a couple months up by my dad's because he has extra rooms in his house and he's got his dog that they're used to. So that's going to be their kind of transition just to make sure everything goes well, make sure I'm not a complete idiot with the trailer and kind of figure out what I'm doing. And then kind of my goals are for this year, 2021, is to go see the Northern Lights. And so I'll go up kind of to Minnesota and maybe Canada. I've got a passport if you guys will let us in. Because the further north you go, the better chances are, even though the summertime. So that's kind of the tricky part is getting in. The summertime isn't that good because of the light, right? I hear.
Well, apparently you can catch them any time of year. There's supposed to be some times that are easier, and that's kind right. of October to May. That's why I had gone out that one night. The biggest thing is like going when there's no moon, you know, the week before that and the 3 days after. My plan is to try to see some more too, but I'm still doing some fixing up on my stuff, so I don't get stranded again.
Well, and that's the tricky part because October, I figured, was the prime time. And I figured if I wasn't up in Canada, I'd go up to like the UP, the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. And that's a good viewing spot, I hear, as far as the U.S. goes. And and so October is kind of the prime time for that because before it gets too cold because I can't stay up there while it's cold. But then I have people like Vandarella Kelly from Vandarella's emailing me like, oh, come join us at Mayberry in October. And I'm like, oh man, that sounds like so much fun, but I don't know. So there's so many conflicting things. I'm like, I'm taking it a month at a time. I'm keeping everything on the radar. I can kind of just go as I want, which is kind of nice, but I like to have kind of a general idea of where I might go.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you think being an analytical mind is going to cause you the need to over plan? Or can you still do it and see to your pants?
It drives them nuts because I do it too much. With the job that I had, we did a lot of traveling and people could not believe it that I would wake up the morning of going to wherever and I had them packed, or sometimes I didn't even have a hotel. I just pack in the morning, throw it all together. You know, we can do the hotels as we go, that sort of thing. So, no, it drove people nuts. I'm not a big planner.
You know what? I think that is going to be really good for your channel, because I think you're going to get into all sorts of epic shit that we're going to want to watch.
You just never know what's going to happen.
So do you own your house, Nate, or are you renting?
I do own it. I don't have a lot of equity in it. I've got a little bit.
And, are you going to sell it or rent it or keep it?
I'm just going to sell it. Get rid of it. I thought about the renting thing. It would be a great rental because I'm close to a good school. They just built a brand new church. It's in a really safe area. And the nice thing is it's one of the smaller ones in a really nice community, not really nice, but a nice community. And it's one of the more affordable ones in an affordable range. And so it would rent really well. But the more I thought about it, I don't want to rental while I'm up in Alaska. Like, what am I going to do if something goes wrong?
Yeah. Yeah. And then you don't have to worry about any expenses connected to the home. I know that's one of the things I worry about. But I mean, I would never be able to pack up and leave my job for 3 years like you're doing. I don't know.
Well, I don't get to go back to it. I don't think.
No, I guess because you left it. So right. You're upgrading your education and then you're going to work part time for now with that friend. How's that going to work when you want to leave?
When I want to leave what?
Or are you going to start working part time when you get back from your travels?
No, I'm going to work part time while I travel.
You have to do it remotely?
That's going to be one of the big tricks, is getting an internet connection that's reliable. I'll probably have to spend some money on that. So he already knows it. He says, I don't care where you're at. That was one thing that made me want to do it this year, because we used to travel. We used to go to the banks, and even the agency felt like you needed to be there. Well, COVID came along, and everybody says it's real bad. And there's a ton of bad things with COVID. But one of the really great things is, not only the technology, people got used to it, but all these companies and even the U.S. government started to realize, why are we paying to send people? Why are we paying for hotels, for their per diem, for their gas, their airplane, all that stuff? They'll still have some of it, but I guarantee you it's going to cut back, because they realize how much we did remotely, and we did it successfully. I mean, I think they said at our agency, like, the productivity dropped like 1 or 2%, and most of that was early on while everybody was adjusting. So I think there's tons of opportunity out there for people to take advantage of this new remote environment that we're in. Not only work, but also the degree is completely remote.
Yeah, I don't know. I know a lot of employers, they're gonna want their people back. I know for myself, I'm working remotely right now, but it can change at any time, and I'm not allowed to travel and do it.
Right.
So, I mean, it just depends, again, yeah, who your employer is. So,
and I could not have stayed at my job that I was at and kept doing this. I just figured that there are going to be jobs out there if I needed one that I could do it. Or if I got to the point where financially I needed to get off the road, I could just stop. And one of the nice things about traveling is you no longer, if you're searching for a job and you're not stuck to like a house, I will no longer be stuck to like the Omaha market, which
went anywhere.
Yep.
That's awesome.
And I'm from California. I grew up in California. Then I went to South Dakota, Iowa, then Nebraska. So I'm kind of used to moving around, and I kind of like living in new areas and experiencing it. So.
Crazy. Oh, I got a comment about the picture behind me. That is a picture painted wrong side by my grandma. Many, many years ago. Thank you. Oh, man. Maybe I should have checked with you with what's okay to ask or not, but
I'm pretty wide open.
What was the preceding event to all of this change? Like, what had to happen in your mind and in your life to all of a sudden go, nope, okay, I'm quitting my job. I'm going to travel for 3 years. I'm going to upgrade my education. Like, any one of those things, Nate, is a huge stressor for most people.
Right. Oh, and it is. I mean, I told my friend that's hiring me, I said, you just got to be aware. I've got a lot going on the next 4 months, and I'm perfectly aware of everything I got to get done. So, but I took a long time to finish my first degree. I think I was 27, 28, 26, 27. I transferred a bunch, all this other stuff. I've always kind of moved around. And I graduated with a lot of debt. Then I had a health thing that I had to pay for a surgery. And so when I graduated in 2009, at the height of the Great Recession with a finance degree, with a bunch of debt, I mean, I was really lucky to get the job that I did. And I always said, I'm gonna, you know, I've had my fun and I've got to do my time now. So I always committed myself to 10 years. And so when I started that job, I always said, I'm going to do it for 10 years, unless something, you know, unless I was really unhappy or something.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm going to do the 10 years. I'm going to pay off my student loans. I'm going to save some money up. And so I kind of did that, but I had recently got a promotion, which is why I came to Omaha. And so I did like an extra year and, you know, I got to the point where I wasn't really happy. I started looking at other jobs, but I kind of felt like, you know, I did a couple of interviews and I started thinking, I'm kind of putting myself in the same spot, right? Am I leaving one thing just to go to kind of a similar situation that maybe it's a change, so I'll be happy for a year, but after that, I'm not. Because like I said, my job didn't really fit my analytical style.
Okay.
And so I kind of had that. And then I started having this crazy idea in my head, like, why am I going for another job right now? I don't need to. And I could go back, get my MBA. I could go travel. And it just stuck in my head. And after a while, one of those things when you think about it so much and at first you think it's crazy. And then after a couple of weeks, you're like, I kind of got to do this. I'll regret it if I don't. So
yeah,
that's kind of the problem.
But so many of us, we don't travel while we still can. And I know I feel really torn. Like, I'm seeing what you're doing, Nate, and I envy you so much to have the courage to do that. Everything that you're doing, it's what I want to do. But at the same time, I know my early retirement can be in 10 years.
Right.
So, but then again, you're younger than I am. So,
and that was part of it. When I looked at it, I said, people were like, you're never going to quit, Nate. You've done too well. You've moved up and you can move up more. Well, one thing is, at the agency I was at, I didn't want to move up any higher. There was no positions that interested me.
Yeah.
And so that was part of it. And then I looked at it. I said, it's been a good job for 11 years, but I don't want to do this for the next 20 to 25. And I was very honest with myself about that. And so I do have friends that are, you know, if you're within 10 years, it makes it that much harder. It's like, well, I've only got to do it for 10 more years. I've put in 20, 30, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. And so when I quit, I thought for sure people were going to, you know, when I put out the announcement, I was going to get all these calls and emails saying, you are absolutely crazy. I thought 90% were going to be like, you're nuts. What are you doing? Can you take it back? And like 10% might be like, that's really cool. And it was completely the opposite. I mean, 90% of the people were from people that I didn't expect calling me up being like, that's really awesome. I wish I had done it at your age because I know the frustration. I know why you're probably doing it, blah, blah, blah. And it was a lot of the people, the lifers that went and did their career for 30 to 35 years that said, if I could have done it earlier. And so they really gave me confidence when they gave me those calls to be like, maybe this crazy idea isn't so crazy. Maybe it really is smart because there is more to life than just working every day, right?
Yeah.
And everybody's situation is different, obviously. I don't have kids. My responsibilities are my dogs. So,
yeah. Wow. Do you ever feel like you're going through an early midlife crisis?
Oh, I don't know. I've always done crazy things. So I don't know.
Yeah, we got a lot of support for you out here. They say you're never going to quit. Nate says, hold my beer. Yeah, move on, Nate. I taught college for 15 years. It's time to move on. Oh, we got a raid from RVDJ. Awesome. Thank you, guys.
Hello, everybody new. If you don't
know. I don't know. I mean, for me, I was shocked, actually, when I bought my ambulance. I wanted to do it. Oh, I wanted to do it. But I'm always one of those person that justifies things away.
Right.
Right? And I'm so glad that I've done it, but I have to kind of step by step, and you just jumped all in.
Well, I left in October, or I left the work in October, and I'm not leaving till April or March. I kind of had a time frame. Mm-hmm. I don't know. So I knew all the steps that were involved before I can go on the road. And so, but yeah, I mean, it was kind of a full commitment. Once I make my decisions, I'm pretty definitive. I don't like to look back in life.
Yeah. Felt like to jump into the community like you have and the response that you've gotten. How would you describe that?
It has been amazing. Like, I had no idea. You know, I started the channel. I didn't know what I was doing. I got like 50 friends basically from the people that I could kind of force from my Facebook group and say, no, you need to go sign up. That sort of thing. And I was stuck for like 2 weeks that I think I was at the 54 number. And then it was D's live, but I think Johnny had to take over because D was having issues. And I just remember there was like 45 minutes of them trying to work it out. They were trying to keep the stream live. And Johnny was like, if anybody wants to come up and say hi,
Life, and she's new to the community too. And she thinks it's great. And she loves them all so much. Yeah, I do too. I was really surprised. I didn't know there was a big community. I didn't know how everybody connected and supported each other. And I was just like in awe.
Exactly. Like I went up for less than 5 minutes. I just held the dog up. I said, I'm Nate. Here's a fluffy dog. And then they were like, come to my live on Tuesday. We'll put you back up. I was like, all right. And I was nervous. I still kind of am. Like after 50 minutes, I'm fine. But I'm an introvert. I'm not naturally a public speaker, but people don't believe me, but it's true. But yeah, it was overwhelming. Like I went on that first one and everybody just started saying hi, said, come to this live. And before I knew it, there were so many that I couldn't like yours. I had you on my list, but I think I was going to Danny's or, you know, there's a lot of overlap. And yeah. So then it was like, oh, after a while, I was like, came over and I was like, why haven't I watched this one? but Wednesdays and Saturdays, there was so much overlap. There's so many lives.
There is.
And they're all fun.
It's, you know, I think with so many people being home and being isolated and the ability to travel has been greatly reduced, that this is... Right. This has been a really great way to reduce the isolation, don't you think?
It really is, especially since, like, I mean, while I was still working, I still had, like, some of these meetings and stuff. But since I quit, it's like I can talk to the dogs all day. But it is kind of nice to come on, even as an introvert, to come on and have the little chit-chats and the panels. And, I mean, a lot of you have become friends to me, you know. It's kind of weird, but.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you kick butt in trivia on the channels. Oh my gosh. I tease you, but you never lose.
I think I've been lucky when you've been watching.
Yeah, no, I did see last night on Danny's channel there that you didn't win that Kahoot, and then I went to bed.
Well, you knew what happened.
That's it. I'm going to sleep.
I was in here testing if this setup was going to work. And so every time I've played Kahoots, I've done it in my office and I've got dual screens. So I've got the Kahoot on one and the answer on the other. But I was in here, so I've only got the one screen and I was trying to do it off my phone because they say you can. And I think I had dropped down to second and my phone, for whatever reason, disconnected.
Right.
I couldn't answer it. I was like, no, I know that one. Come on.
Because, yeah, I think I really first started to get to know you on one of my middle of the night live streams. I couldn't sleep. I popped up. I was experimenting with that game as well. And you just kept winning and winning and winning. I'm like, who is this guy?
I remember that. It was like 2 a.m. and I was like, I got to go to bed. And then your random pop-up came. I was like, what the heck is somebody doing right now? I got to watch this.
Dale Bruce says that he's watched YouTube for years, but only recently started interacting with the people. It's helped me stay sane since being stuck at home since March. I hear you, Dale. Same here.
Yeah.
Same here. And you know, it was in this time too, Nate, that so many people have worked so hard on their channels, right? And I mean, having my channel get to where it is so far has been one of the things I'm thankful for the last year.
Right. It makes you feel like you've accomplished something, right?
Yeah. Yeah. It gives me something positive to look at.
And people don't realize how much work it is. I had no idea, especially when you're learning it all, right? part of it is, you know, doing the videos, responding to the comment. I'm always behind on my comments. I try to catch up and I fall behind again. Mm-hmm. Part of it was I was doing those giveaways that took a lot of extra time the way I set it up. And so I'm kind of happy that, like, I can get it all done and I don't have to do that spreadsheet anymore. But I put that on myself because I was like, I want to try to do something to kind of help grow. And obviously I didn't realize all I needed was a short, but it was still kind of fun to do. And I think I was really happy. I'm happy when people win that I know, but I'm also kind of happy when people win that I don't. And you get to kind of know somebody new if they realize they win. And I had one that was, I can't remember, they had lost their job or something, and a birthday was coming up with their kids and they didn't know what they were going to do. So they were just like, this will be perfect. Thank you so much. So you just never know what you're going to run into with that stuff. So that's one of the reasons I try to get them back out so quick. I said, I've got 8 of them to do. I just want to get them done because I don't know who's in what situation with everything going on. I want to get them out of my hands.
Yeah. Nate, another thing that I noticed about you right away, and a lot of people aren't going to know this, but I'm going to say it anyways. It would have been when Ray with Van Life Rocks was on my channel and we did some giveaways and you had won one, or that was one that I forget. Anyways, you had won and it was one of the things that I was giving away. And I did not know you yet. That was even before I think we had that middle of the night live stream thing going on. And you were the first person to ever send a message saying, you know, thanks, right? But I really want you to send it to another person and I don't want them to know that it was from me.
Right.
I was just like, what a good heart.
And you know, I do those. I put my name in for them because I really do enjoy like getting the stickers, the shirts. I got Hani's shot glasses. Those are the fun ones to me. And the other things that are like gift cards and that. I feel like I'm in a place that there's other people that it makes a bigger difference for, you know. And that was somebody that had done a lot for me on here. So I appreciated that. And I
just thought that was so cool. And you know, to not want any acknowledgement of it. I know people out there, people do have done that. Badge didn't want me to tell anyone the stuff that he did for me, but I did anyways.
I have heard you do that anyways.
You didn't want me to say anything, but I am now. Right. I mean, it just really goes to show your true nature and your heart. And I mean, even with the giveaways, you're investing your money into giving things to others. Like there was a lot of other ways you could have gone about, you know, trying to get viewers and stuff, but it seems like you have this very giving nature about you.
Well, and the nice thing about that for me was, you know, because I've done a lot of travel with work. So I've built up a lot of like Marriott and IHG points. And so when I was looking at that and I was looking at the channel and I saw people doing giveaways and stuff, I had a lot of points that I realized I'm probably not going to be using. At least over the next 3 years, because I'm in a trailer, right? I don't need to go to a hotel. So really what I did was I took some of my points. I didn't reduce them all the way, but I took those and that's how I got the gift cards. So
look at you just trying to be all damn modest, right? Oh, well, I did this. Well, you did a lot of work just to be able to bring some joy into another person's life. And I think that's awesome.
Thank you. That spreadsheet was a lot.
Awesome. And by the way, in case you forget, you guys, I do have Nate's channel in the description of this video, and I do believe my moderators have been dropping it. Yeah, Van Life Rocks recently dropped it. I honestly think you guys, if you haven't checked out Land Cloud Adventures, I think that's something that you definitely need to do. And I can't wait till you do more videos that showcase you as well, because you are funny. I see you on so many live streams and you're part of like you're hilarious.
Sometimes
you have a fun, loving nature about you. And I just can't imagine anyone that wouldn't enjoy watching your videos.
I appreciate that. I'm looking forward to it too. I've done a couple practice ones and I think there's some changes that I need to make. So hopefully they'll get better as far as the longer ones, especially when they get, you know, to 10 to 15 minutes. My first one that I tried to do real seriously was a lot, very, very informational, but not all that entertaining.
Well, I think that's the thing. When we start, we think we have to put out these really big videos, but we don't.
Right.
I like this. Danny says, Nate is a very good dude, no doubt. That is one of the reasons I'm proud to call him a friend. And I bet you probably met him through this whole process, right?
He was one of those first people reaching out. He was, and he's a cool guy. Him and Blaine and Kenny too. I mean, Kenny's an amazing guy.
Yes.
I can't say enough about Kenny.
V says, Nate is a ray of sunshine through some fluffy clouds. That's so awesome. Doesn't that just fit?
You guys are being too nice to me.
So we have hit an hour. Do you guys in the chat have questions for Nate? Because I know I've really been taking up all the time here, but did you expect me to ask so many questions, Nate?
I didn't. I mean, I've watched some of your interviews. I figured you were just going to ask questions and I just answer what I could.
People are so nice. I was interviewed by Karen on Prairie Life and she gave me some questions in advance and everything else. I don't do that for anyone. But I'm not a good planner sometimes. I just wanted to sit and visit with you and they got to watch.
And that's what you do well. It's kind of like when you did it with Dee, not having, you might want some, you know, you probably have a couple ideas of what you're going to ask, right? I imagine. Or you're just so good at it now, you already kind of know what to ask. But you go very well, with, you know, kind of how the conversation goes.
Thanks.
If you just had set questions, you're going to be like, you know, I'll say one thing and then all of a sudden you'll be over, or somebody will be over here with the next question. So.
Mm-hmm. Mike wants to know, when are you live streaming? Do you think that you will start a regular live stream to help you get some of those hours?
I'm going to attempt it. I'm going to start this week. It's going to be a late night one. I don't know how many people will show up, but it's going to be Thursday nights after my class. There's only one class I have a set time for. It's 6 to 9 my time. So I'm going to do a live stream at 10:50 p.m. on Thursdays.
Which time is that?
That's Eastern time. So 9:50 Central, 7:50.
I'll be 9:15 for me. Easy peasy. So, I'll be there. I will be there.
I appreciate that. I figured, trying to figure out where there's slots that I'm not stepping on toes. And people have told me don't worry too much about that. But it kind of made sense because even the weeks that I'll have to work, like maybe Monday through Wednesday or Monday through Thursday, I'm not going to be working a lot of some Fridays, but I'm not going to be working a lot of Fridays even when I do work. And so it kind of just made sense. And that's just kind of when I was comfortable. And it'll probably change. When I go on the road, I was thinking about this. When I go on the road, and I'm in the trailer and I'm in like a campsite. Mm-hmm. I imagine that they're not going to want somebody doing a live stream and making a bunch of noise at 9:50 p.m. I don't know if people will be able to hear or not. So it might change when I start going traveling. But
well, I think it's good that you're being open to whatever presents itself. I think that's the biggest way of, if we're going to have an epic lifestyle, we have got to be open to opportunities. And it just sounds like that's where you're at.
Yeah, I was hesitant to do it because it's not my natural style. Going up and, like I said, I'm an introvert. It's not natural for me. I've worked on it over the years, presenting in front of people. At work, I got to the point where I was doing presentations in front of like 50 bankers and I was scared to death. And they're like, but you're the expert, so go talk to them. And but it's still 50 people out there judging me, you know?
Yeah, but you know, one of the things I found that made it easier for me is knowing that other people have things go wrong too. When I started live streams, every single one for like the first month, I screwed something up. But that was a thing I was learning live, right? I never took the time to learn any of the background stuff about that. I just jumped in. But I mean, there's so many people out to help and they understand. And people have been doing this for so long and they still have things that happen.
Right.
It's really not that big of a deal.
My first attempt, I tried to do it in the middle of the night at 2. And I'd watched somebody. I said, I don't think I'm going to do it. But somebody had told me that StreamYard's free for your first 20 hours. So I thought, what do I have to lose? I'll just go in, hit some things. And it was a complete disaster. I went live. I apparently went live on Facebook instead of StreamYard. And the worst part was, so I hit live and all of a sudden I've got 5 people in there at 2 in the morning. I'm like, no. And I said, I was like, no, you guys aren't supposed to be here. And it was Donnie, it was Kelly, it was Amy. I don't remember, it was Tiffany or whoever. But they were also very helpful. Finally, we figured out that I wasn't actually even on StreamYard. I was like, idiot. But yeah, it's a learning experience, and I was very happy that they were there, even though it was a bit embarrassing, but they were so about it and so helpful about it that's how everybody is around here.
That's that whole surprise of how amazing and supportive everybody is. To start, my son is worried because, you know, you hear trolls and different things like that, and people can be very critical, and I'm a sensitive person. He was worried about me. But that hasn't been my experience. And there's been enough kindness that I could handle a little bit of the opposite, I think.
Right.
I have, like, everybody here that's so amazing and supportive.
You know, the funny thing is, and I remember watching you when you got like 3 thumbs down or something, and you went to like where it doesn't show, and you could tell that it kind of bothered you just watching.
Yeah, it did. I had 6. I regularly have 4 or 5. And the thing is, Nate, they are doing it before I even go live.
Right.
That's the part that's ticking me off.
The hilarious thing to me, so that video that went to like 220,000 had, I can't remember if it was like 300 or 3,000 thumbs downs. And I was like, well, now you know it's a good video if you don't get 1 or 2 or 3. If you get over 100 thumbs down, you did something right. So
I think, though, we're always going to have a certain proportion of negativity with positivity, right?
And I don't know if this is like a real thing or not, but when I worked at the government and I went out to D.C. to work on a project, and they were going over the surveys that they sent out, the employee satisfaction surveys. And there was something that they said, I don't know if it's research or what, but they basically said on those surveys, if you get an 80% positive rate, that's pretty much the highest you're going to get, because there's always going to be 20% of people dissatisfied. And I don't know if that correlates directly to YouTube, because I don't typically see an 80 or 20% thumbs down, but it just goes to show, no matter what.
Out, the more we're pushed out, the more chances there's gonna be people that didn't like it. Right now it's mostly our subscribers, so they're very kind to us, right? But yeah, so that was something that I have been working on. Thanks for calling me on that.
Well, we're all like that. I'm not saying it's you. I mean, I did it too. My first one, I was like, what the heck? And then I got a video with 2, and I was like, who doesn't like, and it was just the dogs. And I was like, who doesn't like my dogs? Like, don't worry me, I don't care. What did they do, you know?
So we have a question. Danny wants to know, what former boy band member does Nate remind me of?
Which way am I supposed to go, Danny?
I'm trying to remember any boy bands.
Oh, come on, you're faking. You didn't watch boy bands?
Oh, I did, but it was a little while ago. Who is it that he's talking about? I know you must know.
Danny's always promoted me as looking like JT, Justin Timberlake. So he was in the boy, was it Backstreet Boys or NSYNC? And then he went on his own. So I guess if I look like this, or I don't know.
Oh, jeez. Danny's very creative.
Well, and then Vanlife Voyages, I won a prize where they were going to do a shootout video for me. And, of course, in their video, like right in the middle of it, they took one of my videos and they say, he's also known as JT around here. And they took the video that they could look most like him. I was like, can't you see it? It's a conspiracy, I tell you.
Apparently, my brother is asking lots of questions. When is this live? I think I'm behind in the chat. So you're talking late night Thursdays.
Basically, okay. Basically, my plan is to 11, just think 11 o'clock Eastern time. But what I'm kind of trying to do is call it 10:50. And my plan is to, from 10:50 to 11, do the hellos and all of that. And I'm going to try at 11 to keep an eye on that and just kind of start the show, even though I don't know what the show is yet. I'm tossing around ideas still.
Mm-hmm. So V wants to know if you're going to go live in your RV on the road for a while before seeing what you need to upgrade, change, or are you going to wing it? That is a good suggestion. I know I need to practice a little more with my systems in the ambulance before I'm on the road doing lives.
I'm going to wing it because, you know, the day I go out in my RV, it's not so much about getting an internet connection that's reliable for YouTube, but for when I do that remote work. I'm going to need something, even if I've got to buy one of the expensive systems to make it reliable. Because doing the work will pay for it. So, and then I'll just be able to use it for YouTube too.
So I don't know if you know this, but Ann Holland is Vox Vandy's sister. And yep. She's Because if Dee can do it, you can do it. And she's not tech savvy.
I love Dee so much.
I do. RVing with G Georgie, no, you do not need 1,000 or 100 friends before you go live if you're using streaming software. I think. Wait, I already had 100 friends before I did it. You might need a certain amount before you can live stream straight with YouTube. But you were live streaming, didn't you, before 100?
No. My 100, after I met you guys, and I didn't, before that, I didn't even really know what live streaming was. But it wasn't long after I met the community that I was over 100. The disappointing story to me was we had a snow, 7 inches of snow here. And it was, I think, the night after or a couple nights after I had done that disaster of a live stream. And so I was like, well, you know what? People like seeing the dogs. They're snow dogs, and we've got 7 inches of snow. So I'm going to go down to the dog park and let them run around. And I'll just do a live stream and play around with it a little bit and let people watch the dogs and the 7 inches of snow that nobody's touched yet. And so I got out there, and the road was part of a local park that they don't typically plow the road. And I got there, and I was like, even with my four-wheel drive, I don't know if I'm going to get in and out. So I went to the closest parking spot, and we hiked about a mile and a half in, because I was set on doing this, just trying it, right? And once I put my mind to something, I'm going to do it. And so we hike a mile and a half in. The dog's already tired by the time we get there. And I go to hit the live stream.
Sorry.
Who invited Derek?
Just keep going.
It's got to be Derek.
Mine are running.
But no, I walked all this way in 7 inches of snow, and we were all tired. And I go to hit the live stream just to try it out. And YouTube says, you're not cool enough to live stream on your phone yet.
Oh, yeah. I don't even know if I can yet, or maybe I can.
I just got the notification this morning. It took a week for them to send it to me, but at 1,000, you can, I think.
Oh, okay.
I should test that out just to be sure, but.
I've looked at it directly through there, but you can't bring up a guest and stuff. And I'm all about bringing people up, right?
Yeah. And I like that too, but I figured for that one, I was just going to let the dogs run around, maybe talk a little bit, get used to it. And I probably wouldn't have, I mean, on my phone, I imagine I can't keep up with the chat. So I was just going to do it for like 20 minutes. And if people watch, they watch. If they didn't, they didn't, but I didn't get to do it at all.
Vanlife Voyages wants to know if you sing.
I don't.
Bye, bye, bye.
I think I did that on somebody's stream. I did the, it was like, bye, bye, bye. Or something. I can't dance either, by the way. And I worked it when I was really young. I hate singing. I don't think I have a good singing voice, but I worked at TGI Fridays when it was really popular and everybody went and had their birthday there. And as the waiter, you had to go sing happy birthday to everybody.
Yeah.
And that was like, I don't know if I want this job. But I did it.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think I could have done it. Rayleigh Creative Travel Blaine says, I see Nate joins y'all on Wednesday's lineup. So Vanlife Rocks, Vanvita Travels, Vanlife with Gina, and then Land Cloud Adventures.
If you're going to say van life, van I don't have van in my name, guys.
You don't have van in your name.
I'd ruin it.
That's not how it goes. That is a good idea, because we just kind of raid from one channel to the next.
Right. Yes. You know, once I get on the road, maybe I'll think about that. What's that?
With school, you need your sleep, young man.
Right. And so that's why I picked Thursday night, because that's when I should be pretty much done with my schoolwork, work that week, if I am working that week. Wednesday, I would probably get myself behind on a couple of those things. So that's what would worry me.
I'm just...
You see Zippo back there?
We have 46 people over an hour later still hear me. That is how entertaining you are.
I don't think they're here for me. They're either here for you or them.
They're all here for Nate, right? Just I'll go Nate, 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 Nate in the chat.
Ah, oh, shucks.
Come on.
See, even with my beard, you're making me blush over here.
Oh, my gosh. That was easy.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't take much.
If you're cool about it, I'm going to make you blush all the time. Everybody does it to me. I had a find someone to pick on too. We got Justin and Christina's RV Van Life in here. The RV DJ, Timmy Ray the King is here. Boondocking with Boomers here is Lance Phillips, TGIF. Wow, there's a lot. RVing with G, creatively created crochet triple C. That is a tongue twister.
I think that's why everybody just calls her triple C.
Yeah, Kenneth is here. Yeah, there is so many people in here. Wow, Van Life Voyages is here. Ronald, hey Ronald, I didn't know you were here.
And Kathleen Klein, I am wearing that loincloth for you.
What?
Oh, long going joke with her.
I want to hear it.
Well, it actually started on your channel, on one of your live streams. Remember somebody, it was her that threw out strip poker.
Channel.
What?
There's so many things that go bananas on this channel. You're going to have to explain it to me. Loincloth.
It was one of the late nights, and Kathleen Klein threw out strip poker of something. Of course, you're like, I am not doing strip poker. And on somebody else's live later, she came on, and I was a panel member, and she started talking about strip poker again. And then she was like, how good are you at poker, Nate? And I said, well, I'm pretty good, I suppose. I can hold my own. And then she was like, okay, well, you got to play strip poker in just a loincloth. I am not strip poker in a loincloth good.
Long hand, and she's like, woohoo!
Right. That video could go viral, though. I might have to think about it.
Video.
What?
I'm going to have to do some kind of little video with something in a loincloth. No, that'll be for you on your channel.
I don't think so.
DJ asked if you had kids, but I think you answered that already. You don't have children?
Nope. I typically say none that I know of, but I'm pretty sure I don't have any kids.
Oh, thank you so much for that, TGIF. Box Vandy is here for as long as her internet holds up.
Right?
That is like even his bald head blushes. It would look really weird if it didn't.
That's probably right? True. Just white and red hair.
Oh, she's like, inside joke. Well, I know it now. Sometimes during the live streams, I miss some of the conversations, right?
And that's There's probably a good thing.
Going on in those chats that I miss, and it's probably for the best.
I agree.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, we had a few different people asking if you had children. And you're not in a relationship, I would imagine, right now. We don't see a partner in any of your videos.
Nope. And I figure with me traveling the next 3 years, it's likely, I mean, going to remain that way with me traveling the whole country. So, and I kind of have kids. But they're just really fluffy white ones. I just don't have the kids.
They're very well-behaved children. And Boondocking with Boomer, thank you for asking everyone for the thumbs up. That's greatly appreciated. Alan wants to know more about the trailer that you have.
So it is a Jayco something flight SLX, and it's basically a 21-foot travel trailer. I'm trying to think, it's 21 feet by 7 feet with one slide out that goes 9 feet. So it's not a whole lot of living space, but I think it'll be plenty for what we need.
And the dogs have their own bed. Is that the bed that you sit on for your videos? Is that the dog's space? Or is that your bed?
It's gonna be, here, this is kind of weird, but okay. So there's that queen size bed that you've seen me on in the videos. And then next to the bathroom, there's bunk beds. Mm-hmm. And so I figured the dogs, especially Pippa, would like the bunk bed because she gets scared. That's kind of the safest spot in the rig. And Dallas, I didn't know where she'd go. She likes to sleep on the floor a lot. She kind of changes it up. And when I went to buy the trailer, I started to climb in the bunk bed to see if it was big enough for me. And the guy's like, well, you won't be sleeping there. You got your bed over here. And I said, I don't know. I'm kind of weird like that. I don't mind. I kind of like sleeping in a tight spot. So I think I might actually end up, and when we were testing it, a lot of the times I just slept on the top bunk. Even though it's kind of made for a kid, it's about 6 feet long. It's just long enough for me. And when you tuck back up in there, it gets really, it's kind of the darkest part of the trailer. And I don't know. I think I slept the best up there. So I've got a couple options.
Sleeping on the bunk beds. Where are the dogs sleeping? In the queen bed?
They can sleep wherever they want. Pippo a lot of time would sleep in the queen bed, and Dallas would typically sleep on the lower bunk. But they change it up too.
But what would happen if you slept in the queen bed? Would they sleep with you, or how does that work?
They can. I don't tell them they can't. I'm a very active sleeper, so I move around a lot. So the dogs don't always want to sleep in the bed with me. So there was a couple times I did sleep in there. One time Pippa stayed the whole night, and then the other time they both left. But it's kind of one of my craziest stories. I don't know what I do in my sleep. I'm very active. I know I move around, but I actually broke one of my ankles in my sleep once. Just to give you an idea of when I sleep, I don't know. I woke up at 2:30 in the morning. I was on my bedroom floor, and I had not only broken but dislocated my left ankle. And
are you a sleepwalker too?
I think for about a year I was. Once I broke my ankle, I don't think I have since.
The pain would wake you up every time you hopped out.
Oh, that's probably the most scared I've ever been in my life. Waking up in like pitch dark, in a lot of pain, not knowing what was going on. I for a little bit, I didn't know where I was. So yeah.
Huh. DJ, I don't have just the music at disposable to me right now to play it just to see the dogs. I'll have to get that sometime. Nate, you'll have to come on the stream and I'll just play the music so we can get the they want to see what the dogs do.
Just to see if they respond just to that.
Yeah. Well, they've definitely been getting some reinforcement for it. Yeah, at the point in time in your life when you broke your ankle, were you under any stress? Was there a lot of changes? Is there anything that was similar in your life now that could be when you're on the road?
So the ankle that I'm talking about, because I've broken both, but the one that I broke in my sleep, the only thing I really remember was I'm a Warriors fan, and they lost to LeBron that night. So I remember, I could go back and tell you the date if I really needed to, because it was the night that they lost game 7. And so I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but it was a bad night for me. But that year leading up to that, I had, I had never slept walk that I knew of before. But the first time that I knew, I did it 3 times that year that I know of. One, I broke my ankle because I clearly was out of bed. The first time that I ever know of, we were sent out to either Pennsylvania or Connecticut in the middle of winter. They had like 20 inches of snow on the ground. And we got there the first night. My hotel room was on the second story. And I woke up at like 3 a.m. and I was walking around in my shorts on the first floor. No idea how I got there. And I had never slept walk before. And I think I woke up because I was so cold. And that was scary. I was like, what am I doing? Like, I was just walking around, wandering around the first floor, and that's not where my room was. And so I remember I saw a bathroom, and I ducked in the bathroom trying to, like, what is going on? Like, get my wits about me. But I was so cold that I couldn't stay there. So I finally went up to the front desk and, like, I don't know what I'm doing out, but I need a key to my room.
Okay, so what are you going to have in place, Nate, in case something like that happens when you're out on the road?
Well, that's part of the fun. You just don't know what's going to happen, you guys. You just hope I catch it on camera.
What about things like, I mean, you could record yourself for sure, but that's not going to stop anything. But I've seen where people put on the outside, and you could put it on the inside, you know, some motion sensor lights that come on. So when you start moving, the light will come on, at least aimed around the door area, so it's not shining every time the dogs move. But I mean, it's
at the time I didn't have the dogs, so the dogs would probably wake up too and maybe wake me up. I don't know.
Is what's gonna happen.
What?
They're gonna end up stranded outside with you if you start wandering around. And Shanna wants to know, were cocktails involved?
When I broke my ankle, I did have some beers that night. I don't think I had all that many, but like I said, I wandered out of the hotel the one night, and then there was another night in my own house that I just was in another room, and I woke up walking around, and then I broke my ankle. And after I broke my ankle, I don't think I have again. And that was
just haven't done anything dramatic.
Right. I haven't broken anything since.
Mrs. Laurie says, wear an electric fencer to the door handle. Or wire an electric door fencer to the door handle of your rig. That would work. Oh. Well, I think that's a legitimate concern in a new environment. You're so worried about how it's that the dogs have adapted, but you're going to have to be careful. Like, if you've gone to the point you broke an ankle and don't know how you did it.
Right.
We don't want to see bad things happen to you, Nate, although some videos of your night's sleep could make for some interesting YouTube videos.
I joked about it at the time that I was going to get a GoPro and set up a live stream. I didn't think YouTube had live streams. I didn't know what I was, but I was always joking. Like, people would probably just watch me sleep because you just don't know what's going to happen. And then there was the other story. I didn't sleepwalk, but the year after I broke my ankle, so maybe 4 or 5 years ago, I went out and I worked in Detroit with like some community groups for 3 months. And I was dating a girl. And so we went to downtown Detroit one weekend and we got a nice hotel out on like the river that splits Detroit and Windsor. And we were like on the 40th floor or whatever it was. And so she knew about my broken ankle. And she said, I remember the dream that I had. But when she woke me up, she said I was literally, you know, I was laying on my side and I was like running in place. Is what she said I was doing. And she was worried that I was going to get up and like bolt out the door or something. But I remember I was having a dream of one of my best friends and I when we were growing up and we were running from like a gang or something. So I was running in my dream and apparently I was physically running sideways.
Yeah. It makes sense to have the dream fit with you doing that. Sheldon, thanks so much, Fantastic Life Adventures, for coming in. We will stay safe. Yeah, I do think Karen's right. You need a motion-activated wildlife camera and a ding-dong alert on the door latch.
Somebody said I just needed to handcuff one of my arms to the bed. But not in the stream, but before.
That would be an interesting live stream for a night. Dream. All right, everyone, I'm going to handcuff myself now.
And just don't lose the key, right?
Oh. How would you explain that? Keep your phone nearby and hope you didn't throw it in the middle of your sleep.
Right.
Oh, we're just getting silly, silly, silly. So if there was one thing that you wanted to tell everyone about yourself or your channel, what do you think that would be? What do you want people to know about Nate?
About me personally? I don't know what I want people to know about me. I just hope that, you know, when I make the content and when people come watch the videos, I just hope that either they're learning something, they're having some fun with it, and especially the shorts, I'm just trying to put a smile on somebody's face for the day in like 15 seconds. That's kind of my goal right now.
That's awesome.
But otherwise with me, I guess you probably have learned this tonight. You just don't know what you're going to get. So.
That's what makes it so fun. So again, you guys, remember, if you haven't already taken a look at his channel, the link for Nate's channel is in the description below. And yeah, don't handcuff yourself. Kathleen says you're going to dislocate your shoulder.
Yeah, that's better than a broken ankle, though. If I got a pick.
Oh, my gosh. Nate, I really want to thank you for coming up and doing this.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it. I've had fun. I figured I would.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Probably too much fun. We could probably do this for hours, but.
Right.
But we won't.
You got to let people know about me slowly over the next 6 months, right? You got a little piece of
mystery in there. Although he wants to know, what is your 10-year goal?
Be happy still?
Retire again?
If I go back to work, and if I, well, other than this other job, but if I go back to work after my MBA, it'll probably be in like, commercial banking or investment portfolio management, something like that. That's analytical, that kind of keeps me awake during the day. And if I did that, I would imagine in 10 years, I would be working.
Mm-hmm.
I don't oppose working as long as it's not entertaining, but you know, challenging and keeps you going.
We got to keep making the fluffy dog videos. They make me smile. We could all use something to put a smile on our face. Great interview. And then there's DJ. Who's Nate? I thought this was the dog's interview.
Coming from the guy that the other night was like, Nate's famous. He's been telling everybody they're famous.
Yeah. No, he does that to you and Ray.
Right.
Yeah, no, that's pretty good. It was funny. What does this say? Funny things happen. Got a call one day. A lady I knew put her toe in the water faucet and got it stuck. Really, Ron? No. No kidding. That was interesting. Oh, my goodness. Here's your next career. Band management? Cheeky, cheeky. That's why we like them.
Well, I love those two.
They are so funny. Thank you, Lance. You have a good night, too. Thank you, everybody in the chat, for being here and hanging out with us. Absolutely. So thank you again. I'm just going to play our little farewell to everyone. Good night, everyone. See you Wednesday.